Hello and welcome to this PSTrace tutorial video. Today, I would like to show you how to operate a multiplexer in PSTrace. For that purpose, I have already connected my MUX8R2, which is my multiplexer, to my potentiostat, which is the palm sense 4. On every odd channel, we have connected a dummy cell. I already connected the potentiostat via Bluetooth to the software, so we can get started immediately. In the software, you first have to tell the software that there is a multiplexer. So you go for tools, general settings, and here you check the box multiplexer present. The multiplexer we're using is the MUX8R2, and that is also then the one that you would be choosing here. Once you say okay, you find now that in the method editor, a little tab was added for the multiplexer. There I have to tell the software what I want to do with the multiplexer. There are different options. No multiplexer means you don't use a multiplexer. In the consecutive mode, you will perform measurements at different channels, and every time you have finished a measurement, you will go to the next channel. Let's just mark the odd channels because they are the ones that have the dummy cell. Then we go back to our measurement, and as you fill in the parameter as usual, and then you can just run your measurement and the software takes care of everything. So you see, we're running, I'm doing just some very LSVs so you don't have to wait so long. So you see that we get a curve for every channel and all the data is stored in the same measurement. So that was the consecutive mode. This is one way of operating the multiplexer. Another way of operating the multiplexer is the alternating mode. So in the consecutive mode, as I said, you finish a measurement, then you go to the next channel, do a measurement, next channel. Alternating mode is a different option. There, you make a point of the measurement, then you go to the next channel, you make a point of the measurement, go to the next channel, and once you're through all the channels, you go back to the first channel. Let me just show you how that looks in PSTrace. Because one important thing is that the alternating mode is limited to certain techniques, because, you know, everything has to go very fast with the channel switching, so we only can have certain techniques. One of these techniques is chronoamperometry. So now I can select the alternating mode. With the alternating mode, you cannot select just random channels, but you have to start at one, and then you choose how many channels you want. Let me just choose, for example, four channels. So I would have two channels where nothing is connected, which are the 2 and 4, and two channels where a dummy cell is connected. Just as a remark, also, you can use this for OCP measurements. However, if you want to measure OCP in the alternating mode, we have a special application note for that. The link will be in the description. Let's go back to the measurement. We do a chronoamperometry. So I'm just trying to make this quick. Very good. And I just make a new measurement. And now you see two curves that are growing in parallel. And I put this here in air quotes, because, as I said, well, it's still a multiplexer, and you know a multiplexer can only control one set of electrodes at the same time. So actually the points are not made exactly at the same time, but there is a bit of offset between it. If you want perfectly parallel measurements, you would have to buy a multi-channel instrument. So this is how this works. We see here two different curves. We see the curves of channel 4 and 2, which are the ones where nothing was connected, and the ones of the dummy cell, which acts here basically just like a resistor in that situation. We see channel 1 and 3 here. Okay, so these are the ways of operating your multiplexer in principle, but there are some settings I would like to talk about that you can do. Okay, so here you see the settings, and there are three checkboxes. One of them is to connect the sense to the WE. For most of the potentiostats, that will not be important. The palm sense 4 doesn't have a sense lead, but for example, the MSTED 3 Plus Blue has a sense lead. Also in the future, there will be more potentiostats with sense lead and auxiliary port. Maybe subscribe to our LinkedIn channel so you don't miss that information. So you connect the sense lead to the working electrode inside the multiplexer so that on the other side, you only connect the working electrodes. However, as I said, for most potentiostats, that will not be very relevant. The next option may be more, which is combine RE and CE. Just like the previous option, you connect the CE lead to the RE lead inside the multiplexer. And then on the other side, only the black cable needs to be connected because the black cable, the black plug is now the counter and reference electrode. So the blue plug, which is usually a reference electrode, is no longer needed. This is only if you want to have a two electrode setup. The third checkbox is to use common RE and CE on channel 1. That's more important one. This is what you do when you want multiple working electrodes to share one reference and counter. So different ways of using the multiplexer is putting 3 electrodes in 8 different cells, putting 2 electrodes in 8 different cells, or putting a reference and a counter or a combined reference counter plus multiple working electrodes in the same cell. And the last two situations, so when you have multiple working electrodes in the same cell, you use this checkbox. Because what it does it stops the reference and counter electrode from multiplexing. You will use the same reference and counter electrode through the whole measurement so that when the channel switches, only the working electrode switches. And if you buy the our double shielded cable for your multiplexer, you will have on channel 1 labels for the RE1 and CE1 that also say RE common and CE common. That just helps you remembering that these are then the RE and the CE that will be used during the measurement. Then the last setting is what to do with your unselected working electrodes. One of them is disconnect unselected working electrode, and unselected working electrode means here the one that's not under potential control right now. So if I do a consecutive measurement with 4 channels, channel 1 is measuring, that means 2, 3, and 4 are the unselected working electrodes. With the first option that they are disconnected, that they're floating, that just means there's no potential control, they will just drift towards the OCP. Other option is that all these working electrodes would be switched to ground, which practically mean these electrodes experience the same potential as the active working electrode if they are in the same cell and share the RE and CE. So that would be this settings window. So let's have a look at another option, how to control your potentiostat. You can also control your potentiostat with the scripting window. So you just saw under script, open script window, I opened the script window and there are 3 commands that help you to control your multiplexer as well, which are set channel, next channel, and previous channel. That's exactly what they do. So when you have set channels, you will have one specific channel. For example, you have set channel 1. You can also, for example, give specific settings to your multiplexer through this command. Next channel just means, well, you select the next channel. And previous channel means you go to one lower channel. I've written here a small script that will perform a measurement, an LSV, that gets shorter every time it's performed. And it only is performed at the odd channels. So I can just quickly run it to show you guys. Oh well, first clear my plot, clear plot, that we get new and fresh curves. So now it's running on channel 1 and you can see on the LEDs always which channel it is. So now we're already at channel 5 and then we're going to channel 7. You see that every time we made a measurement, the ending potential got a bit lower, and this is why now in our graph, we can still see all 4 colors. This is everything that I wanted to show you. So thanks for watching and have a great day.